Hello all, in this tutorial I'll be showing you how to create drawing sheet of an exploded view of a revolving center. For this session I'm considering revolving center as the assembly drawing, where I have presented you all the individual components and assembly and the exploded view videos in my previous video lectures. I have published them all and I got a very good response from all you guys. Thank you so much for that. And in this video I'll be showing you how to create a drawing of that particular exploded view, followed by I'm going to show you how to create bill of materials table. And today I'm going to show you one more important point which I haven't shown you in my previous videos, where I'm going to edit the bill of materials table to create different, how to assign different materials to it. Assigning material inside, not in the table itself. Let me say okay to this. Let me fit it to the screen. Then I'll just alright. Let me browse that assembly from revolving center. I'll go with this assembly. It will take some fraction of seconds. Alright. Now the yes, and one more is, let me keep this one. Yes, I have placed some views over here. Okay, and let me escape from this window, fit it to the screen, and let me take these windows. Let me increase the size of this particular viewport. I'm considering this as a viewport, taking it down. I can use custom scale and I can go with 1:1 ratio. Yes, it is fine. And let me move somewhat, somewhere here. You might have understood now what is the difference between a viewport and a normal window, where we convert from world coordinates to screen coordinates. Okay. Now, after this, let me keep the component in solid with high quality. Alright, this is done. Alright, and one more important point, this one. Let me increase the scale of this component also. Just by going through the custom scaling option, I can increase the size to 1:1. Is it fine or not? Let me check it out. It is going out completely. Let me scale it down 1:2, somewhat better. Fine. Okay, this is okay. And now you can, now I have shown you different options in my previous videos, how to section the component and all the stuff. The same stuff again I just try to show you. A view is not required here. Let me delete. All right further can be increased, I think so. That we can do. What I can do here is custom scale, that is 1:1 is going out. So can anything any else what else can be done? 1:2. All right let it be in this ratio only, 1:1. Just for your understanding purpose, let it be. Okay, and because we are going to collapse the same, not a problem. This is the disassembly which is positioned in isometric, and this is the disassembly which is positioned in front view. The same component, what we can do is we can collapse it. Just have a look. Okay, and I can increase the size further because I want to show you both in one. Okay, so that you have a better idea about a component. This is how it looks like. All right, and it can further be taken this side. Yeah, got it. Everything is done. Now, as you know how to give a bomb balloons also of a material and all, but now in this session I'm going to present you some editing options of bill of material. Let me go with table, bill of materials. I'll select this as my view. And here, as I said, you can go with different options, change them all, trial and error, do it. And I'm going with the templates. Here I'm going to select BOM bill of material standard. Okay, and let me say okay to this. I can place it here. Let us have try to understand the difference between standard and the other tables. Here you could see the item number, part number, description. This is not supposed to be part number, part name it is supposed to be. If you want to change it to part name, double click on it and you can change number by name. That can be done. If you want to change the description, that can also be changed. Okay, if you want to delete this column, you can directly right click on it and say delete column. That can be done. Okay, we'll see some other options. I'll go with table bill of materials of this particular view. Go with templates. This time I just select BOM balloons bill of materials of material. Okay, now let us have a look at the difference between these two. Initially we got item number, part number, description and quantity. Now it is part number followed by description and material. Okay, if you want to give some description related to barrel, that can be given. Even the materials can also be assigned. Let us try to assign few materials to a few of the parts here, which are barrel, sleeve, cover, center. These are all different names given by myself when I have created individual components, and when I saved them in the database, I have given these as the names. Okay, and I haven't given assigned any material there. Okay, you can assign material there. Whatever you have assigned, same name can be given here. We haven't given any material over here. Okay, I have shown you how to use appearances, but for this case we'll try to assign some material to this. Maybe for barrel, cast iron, sleeve, some other maybe mild steel or brass or copper, some other different names we'll try to give here. How to give naming here, I'll just try to give for two or three different components for your understanding. Click on barrel, right click on barrel, go to open barrel standard. Okay, now you go into part drawing. Okay, in this part drawing, click on right click on materials and you can assign whatever the material you would like to assign. Malleable cast iron is one option I'm going to select. Okay, it got assigned now, but here in properties you need to make sure of that medical material. If you go to properties, summary information, under custom options, here you find different option, property name. Here what I want to give is a material I'm going to assign. Here again the material is option, malleable cast iron, whichever we have selected in part drawing, same got assigned here. Okay, in a similar fashion, you have a description there. Let me keep it description, and I would like to give a description over here. Description is main body, main part. Let me name it as, for our understanding, I'm calling this as the main part. Okay, and let me say okay to this. All right, click on this and say save it. Okay, the same information going to be saved in the draft sheet also. Just have a look. Initially this main part name was not there, malleable cast iron was not there, but we have assigned it. Quantity is one, it is a made of, it is a barrel, the name is barrel. Okay, similarly I'll just go with sleeve, right click and open sleeve. Now this sleeve may be made of some copper. Let me right click on materials, let me give copper to it, given. Okay, properties, custom, what is this? This is again material which we are trying to assign. Keep it as material copper, done. Okay, you can save this model. Same thing going to reflect on that particular window. Have a look. Copper description we haven't given any, so likewise you can try them all. Give your own description, own materials. This is supposed to be part number, double click, and let me change this number to name. Okay, everything can be changed, font size, font colors, every other thing can also be changed, which is very much easy to do. Size of the font, or style of the font. If you want, you can keep everything in bold also. I'll show you once again. I'll try to keep everything central text bold. Alright, we are trying to maintain boldness and also increase the size also. That is also possible. Okay, and if you want to increase the size of the table, that can even be done. This is possible. And adjustment of rows and columns, every other thing is possible the way we do in, you know, normal Word window or Excel window. Every other thing is so easy and important to do before going for printing or before applying anything else. Okay, now when the materials are assigned, every other thing is done, it becomes easy for us to give auto balloons. Okay, this I have shown you already on this view. So based on this sequential order, number one is barrel, number two sleeve, number three cover, same order will be followed here. Okay, now I want to keep everything, all the balloons on the maybe top. Just have a look, I kept them all top. Alright, this is how I made it. And if you want to keep it in sequential order, even that can be done. Okay, or according to the assembly, that is also can be done so easily. Every other thing I have explained you in my previous video lectures, you can just go through them all and try them all. Practice makes you perfect. Okay, and likewise I have shown you two different options. You can go with bill of materials of maybe this view, followed by different other templates are also available other than material. You can go with weight, weldments, that also you can try if you have those options. Other than this, if you click on the table, if you want to edit further, you can do that practice also. Now here you could see part number one, how actually part number look like. Part number one, part number two, part number three, four, cross check them all. Means the way you have given balloons in the same sequential order, it will showing the material. Number six. Number six is a screw. That screw is this one. Just have a look. You can see them all in sequential order. This is how window is fixed. Okay, same window can be sent for the to the shop floor for manufacturing. Maybe this is for better understanding of the student, better understanding of the client, to make him understand like the component assembly or disassembly going to be something like this after manufacturing. And when you actually want to manufacture the components, this is not required. You need to give the projections of individual component, front view, top view, side views, followed by dimensions and geometrical tolerances, which is very much helpful to manufacture the component. Okay, now my intention is to show you how to edit this particular bill of materials table, how to edit description, how to delete the row, how to give materials, you know, every other thing I will try to show you in this particular video. Try to concentrate, try to focus more and more on this. In my next video, maybe I focus on some more important points related to geometrical tolerances, how to give surface roughness symbols, machining symbols, you know, some other you know, geometrical tolerance symbol like concentricity, cylindricity, eccentricity, some other values like 0.3, you know, in between contact area, that every leader line, how to give a leader line, every other thing I'll try to explain in my upcoming videos. Now this is all for this particular video. If you have anything to ask, you can comment in the box given below. Thank you so much for watching and for your support. Thank you.